When a person's world comes crashing down and they see that they could change, but they're terrified or they really don't want to, and either due to family or work or friends, or possibly just a little bit of hope, they think, maybe it's time, maybe I could do this, maybe someone else has, and they begin to explore what recovery could look like for them. I have a friend who is, like myself, been clean and dry for decades, and he's a pilot. It reminded me, speaking with a friend of mine, the challenges pilots and professionals have with the, let's call it a stigma, let's call it an expectation. And these are expectations and stigmas within the person's own mind. We're not going to even include the outside at this time, meaning what your friends, associates, family, colleagues might think of your drinking or smoking or not smoking, not drinking, not using. If you're in the trades, you know, it's like, come on out for a beer. If you're in the markets, a way to relax, or the big party, the celebration. If you're in other fields, could be firefighting, cop, usually that means alcohol. And there's always, if you live in BC, a lot of room, maybe not such a good idea, but a lot of room for weed and vaping and all the rest of it. Even magic mushrooms, psychedelics, and exploring all that other world of escape or options. What does this have to do with getting off of alcohol, getting off of drugs? I was living in Whistler looking to get a place with my girlfriend at the time. And I met two pilots. One pilot had a rental that he wanted to rent out. And we decided to meet in the village. He was with another pilot buddy of his, and they were both on break between, I guess they were off for a couple of days or week. And they were smoking cigarettes and drinking beer on the patio. It was a beautiful summer day in Whistler. And I met them, and the very first thing, the pilot who's going to be renting me this suite said is, oh, you want to have a sit down, have a drink, and you smoke? And I said, nope, I actually don't drink and don't smoke. And I'm thinking that this would rate me higher on his acceptability level. I'm renting out his place for a couple of seasons, and you know, I thought this would be a good thing. And it was true. You know, I didn't smoke, didn't drink. And his response was quite telling. He goes, you don't smoke, you don't drink. What are you, sick? And I smiled, and so did my girlfriend, and kind of chuckled at the time. And the two boys were, you know, puffing away on their smokes and drinking their beers. And after talking to him a little bit, they said, it sounds like you'll be an okay guy, and, you know, get back to me, and, you know, we'll probably rent it to you. I said, okay. And sure enough, within a day or two, the place was mine, and everything was fine. Now, small story. What was the expectation of him? Now, he's a pilot. He's responsible for the lives of, at least in his case, he was flying across Canada, so for Air Canada, and he was responsible for probably a couple hundred passengers or more at a time, and the flight crew, and anyone else who happened to be in the air. And it was nothing for him to be, you know, I don't say he was getting plastered, but he was definitely beyond 0.08, okay? So in the whole world of relax, have a beer, have a smoke, whatever. What are the challenges for you? And are those challenges so great that you feel that those challenges, you could not overcome them, even if you were in a crisis situation, or you simply came to an end of road and you realized you had to make a change? Well, that's what recovery coaching is about, is actually how to navigate those changes so you retain your integrity. And not only that, but you find out who you really are. Where did these ideas come from? Why is it normal to be smoking and drinking? Why is that? Why is it normal to get enhanced with psychedelics or weed or other drugs or pharma even? How come that's normal? Are you living someone else's expectations or your own? Or did you just run into what appeared to be a barrier or stop, and then God, you just had to do something different, and you know, it was like, okay, so you came to your end of the road and you chose drugs or booze. You chose temporary escape or reprieve from what seemed to be an inescapable situation. That's what recovery coaching is for, helping you navigate through that, so that you can gain yourself back, your self-integrity back, and who knows, maybe even your health, your income, your spouse, your job, and an extra 5, 10, or 20 years added to your life. My name's Anthony. I'm a recovery coach. I've been recovery coaching individuals for quite a few years now, specifically as a registered, meaning, you know, certified recovery coach, a couple of years, almost three. But prior to that, I've been coaching people for over 20. I am a consultant for over 20 years. I consulted about 20,000 people, families, and toured rehab facilities, spoke with dozens and dozens of different individuals on what recovery is, what it isn't, what their strategy is. And I'd love to share with you what works for them, what works for others, and more importantly, find out what's going to work for you so you can actually not only get on with your life, but get out of that stuck place where there doesn't seem to be a solution, or all solutions lead to either uncomfortable desperation, pain and quiet suffering, or the stuff that you just don't want to talk about and you're afraid to talk about because things could even get worse. I feel like I can be that safe person, because for lots of reasons, I am not a believer or a forwarder of the label everyone and armchair labeler. Don't go there. I'm completely a holistic coach. That's it for this particular talk. This is on professional rehab and professional recovery coaching for professionals. Contact me. You can find me at yourrehab.coach. Give me a text. Give me a call.